Who'll Save Your Soul is the first song I ever wrote. I was 16. I was going to school in Michigan at the time and didn't have money to make it back to Alaska for spring break. And so my idea was learning four chords on the guitar and then hitchhiking across the country. And so I'd make up lyrics, you know, people living their lives for you on your TV. You see, you think they're better than you and you agree. I just started improvising it, making it up. And I would take the change and go to the ticket counter and see how far it would get me. And I made it down to Tijuana, and then I hitchhiked to Cabo. And I'd sing in restaurants for burritos and made it back to school without being murdered. So it was a total success. The first time I heard Who'll Save Your Soul on the radio, I was on the 15 freeway in San Diego, and Nirvana was playing. And then I heard the intro to Who'll Save Your Soul. I was like, I couldn't believe it. Yeah, I pulled over on the side of the road and just started to sob and cry, because it really wasn't until that moment that I realized that I sang like Kermit the Frog. I was so nervous in the studio and so inexperienced that my throat just really tightened up, and I just sang like Kermit the Frog all over that record. Like, if people go back and listen, it was like, who will save your soul? And You Were Meant for Me was the same as like, dreams last, and I don't sing like that. Like, it was so embarrassing, but it ended up being embarrassing all the way to the bank, so it worked out.